All right, I'm waiting for countertops to show up, but I got this box. This box is the magic for the bathroom countertops. Let's open it and check it out. I've never done anything like this. I've never seen anything like this done, but I know it can be done. And I've seen pictures on the internet. That counts, right? So what this is, these are light panels. You don't want to know how much they cost. I regret at times some of the things I do. But it's just a little 12-volt light panel. And I'm gonna put this under the onyx that's see-through. It's a see-through stone. And that whole countertop will light up. Let me show you. So, pardon the mess. The bathroom's clearly not done yet. This blocked off switch, I'm gonna break this back open and I'm gonna run this wire down to a power source in the cabinet for the countertop. I've got a top mount sink that's gonna sit on there that actually matches the tub somewhat. The rock salt light, I'm gonna close the toilet because blue water, nobody wants to see that. The rock salt light's super cool, and I figured if I can get this backlit, it would kind of do the same thing as the rock salt light, and then, I don't know, put some kind of a fake plant or something. I honestly have no idea. But for now, these are incredible, and you can cut them. That's what I'm nervous about, but it's gonna be super, super awesome. Let's go do this. Okay, these are the light panels. What I need to do is build a base out of this, what is that, 5/8 or so. I need to build a base 2 foot by 3 foot. Then I need to notch out. I'll probably do like a 3/8 notch here to run the wires. Then I'll run the wires all the way to the side, or to the center. And then off the cabinet, we'll drill a hole to go down to the transformer. And this is going to light up and be our bathroom sink countertop. Here's the process. Okay, here's our base piece, 36 inches by 24 inches, or 3 foot by 2 foot. Now, I'm gonna cut out my 3/8 by 3/8 notches on 3 sides, and we'll keep going. Okay, to do this, I've got my blade width set at 3/8. And the depth set at 3/8. Then I'm just gonna run it through the saw both directions. I've got 3 sides to do, and then I'll show you the result. Okay, so I've got my notches cut out of there. It's not absolutely perfect, but it's perfect enough to be covered up with that onyx. So now I'm gonna go measure in the bathroom how far from the wall. If I'm standing at the vanity, this is the way I would be facing the vanity, the way this is set up, okay? The light, the power supply for those lights is gonna come along these troughs that we cut out. And then we're gonna bring them around here. the power box is going to be in the cabinet down here. Now what I need to do is measure from the wall how far I need to go to the inside of the cabinet, because now I need to do a dado, and I'll show you how I'm going to do that without a dado blade, that far in, and then cut a hole for the wires to go down. So let's go measure that. All right, so I went and I measured the cabinet. I need to be about 3 inches. So I went a little bit more than that. I'd rather have it more than not enough. And I'll show you later once I get the old countertop taken off. 3 inches, and then right around the, just about halfway. So now I'm gonna go and dado this out and then drill a hole. So that, again, the wires are gonna come along here for each of these panels, and then they're gonna come in that line and drop down that hole. Pretty cool. To do this without the router, I've just set the blade depth to match what I did with the table saw. Now I'm just gonna run it on my marks there, just far enough to match up with the hole. I think I'll actually drill the hole first. That'll be easier. So I'll go grab a drill bit and drill that. It's not as easy one-handed as I had hoped, but that's all right, that'll work for us. Okay, now we'll trench that out with the saw. Okay, so all I did was run it back and forth a bunch. And that's my result. I will take a flathead screwdriver, or a chisel would be the appropriate tool. Clean all that out just so it's smooth. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna have basically 4 wires following along here, coming in here and dropping down into the cabinet, okay? That's the quick and easy way of doing this without a router or a dado blade. Next step. Okay, so now I'm in the kitchen. I've got some just red and black wire left over from the van. I'm gonna cut these lengths so these panels will sit just like this on the countertop, right? I'm gonna cut some lengths to run all these wires to connect to each panel, and then bring them back here, like we talked about outside, to drop down. Okay, Mom's over there sewing. Jordan's over here. Here's Dad. Here's our light panels and our little base we built yesterday. Got all my Hokie wires up to that deal and plugged in. And that's these stone glow panels. And that's the material we're putting on it. It'll be cool. Super awesome. Ba, 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 ba. Now what? Okay, I wired up the rest of it. All the panels light up, so that's good. Here's what the stone looks like on the counter. I've got to go through with the heat gun, and these are heat shrink butt joints, so I'm gonna shrink those all up. and then do something to contain all the wires better. I don't know what yet, but that will work. Cool. Okay, I'm out in the garage. I've got the heat gun. These are shrink wrap, basically. So I'm gonna warm these all up. Then we'll finish putting this panel together. We'll glue these down and we'll install this whole substrate system on the cabinet in the bathroom. And tomorrow they'll bring the Onyx over. Set it in place, drill the holes, and light it up. Got those all shrink wrapped. Now I'm gonna use the silicone to fasten these light panels to the piece of plywood that we've cut. Then I'm gonna put the tape on to hold them all in place, let it cure overnight, and then put it in place for tomorrow. Okay, it is all siliconed in place and drying. I've got the blue tape holding everything in place. Now we just wait. We can unplug it and let it cure. Okay, I've got a hole drilled in the cabinet and I just need to bring a wire from that switch straight down. Got the bit, we're gonna drill through that travertine. And then run a fish tape. Okay, I've got a wire run through there up to my switch. Now I'm gonna run this one wire. Well, I gotta connect it to the power. So this is a constant hot, the outlet. And then I'm gonna run it through the switch. Okay, the box is re-secured. Now I'm gonna run the power from the outlet to the switch and the wire. Okay, I've got the switch wired. Now I need to connect these two to the outlet, the GFI outlet. Put that all back. And then I set up a outlet box down here. The little 12 volt transformer is gonna, or LED driver is gonna hang right there. Outlet box right there. And that'll all plug in. It'll be done. So I've decided I'm just gonna hardwire this. That's basically where I'm not gonna put the outlet on. I've got the hanger there. I'm just gonna run the wire straight into the driver box here. Through that red grommet, and that'll be it. All right, so that's an instant water heater, just so you know if there's questions on that. Now it's all set, I'm gonna put the countertop on with the lights, the substrate thing. Wire the lights, make sure they all work, then we'll do the Onyx. Okay, we've got that set in place and wired. We're gonna leave the lights on while we do the drilling and whatever. I put blue tape around the back to hold all the wiring in the groove we've cut. The front I'm gonna leave open. I might put a rope light around the edge to light up the bottom because I don't think this bottom edge will light up. But here's the switch and it works. What do you think, Dad?
And there were angels.
So these panels are, they're called Sun Glow. I got them from Diffusco. I'm not quite sure how to pronounce it. Supply in Tempe, Arizona. Oddly enough, I found them on the internet. They were the only dealer I could find for this product. And they happened to be local. So that was kind of cool. And what it is, it's just a plastic panel. You can drill or cut anywhere here in the field. And there's certain areas they give you measurements where you can cut the panels this way. The light strip is right here, you can see. And the rest of this is just plastic you can cut. So what we're gonna do, once they get the Onyx here, we're gonna set the Onyx on the countertop. Let me go wide angle. We'll set the Onyx on the countertop. We'll position the sink. I think I kind of want it like that, and then the faucet kind of in the corner, something like that. It just seems fancy, right? I don't know. Then we'll set that in place. They'll drill the holes through the Onyx, through the plastic, and then through the sub stuff. And that's it. We'll put it together, silicone the edges. Maybe not. I kind of like it without the silicone, I think. But we'll have to do some to kind of seal it all up, make it nice. Anyways, that's that product. I'll put link down in the comments and stuff. Thanks for watching. Here's the magic. Perfect.
Oh, wow.
So cool.
Yeah. Perfect. Yeah.
Awesome. That is incredible looking. Almost want to leave it just like that, right? Insanely beautiful. So cool. Center. And we're gonna set the sink up and figure out where we need to drill that hole. This is nighttime. It's dark outside. Plenty of light from that countertop.